O'Connell returns for another day at the co-host desk. All next on Live.
Your shoe. That was not Kelly's fault. It got caught on one of the fibers of this carpet.
Yeah, it happens. This carpet, it gives more than it takes, or it takes more than it gives.
We had a Cinderella moment there.
We did.
It's a good thing your pedicure is up to snuff.
No, it's not. Nothing is up to snuff right now.
Oh, it looked pretty good to me.
It's all. If you look at it fast, like this. How was your night?
Good. Went out to dinner with some friends. Called it early. Watched the Obama last address. That was very emotional. You know what really gets me? Because I have two daughters,
yeah.
And to see his daughters crying there, that really, it's emotional, you know? I mean, what a journey, 8 years, and he was a great president, and it was really emotional.
Yeah, it was, and it was interesting. I watched it as well, and we called the kids up. We're like, you know, because whenever there's a big political speech, I like the kids to be a part of it, to see it, like, let's be a part of this together. And my daughter is like, I can't. I'm studying for exams. And because she has her midterm final exams.
Right.
And I'm like, I was like, you can take time. You can take a little time out of your schedule to watch this. So we are watching, and they cut to the crowd, and you see his elder daughter, but not his Sasha.
Right.
And Lola's, and I was like, I wonder where Sasha is. Is Sasha the 15-year-old? Yeah. And my daughter's like, she's probably home studying for exams. And sure enough, they reported today that she had a school obligation, and that's why she wasn't there.
Wow. That's amazing. My children look for any excuse not to study.
Yeah.
Like, they're like, Dad, the president's on. We don't have to study. Come on.
Right. Well, they're 8, though, so it's still, like, it's still fun. Like, school's still like, yay, school.
Well, school, I can still do it, you know? Can you do Lola's homework?
Oh no! Like not for like 7 years. No. For like 7 years, I've been dumbed out of her homework.
Like the math. Definitely not the math.
Oh, definitely not the math. And the math is so hard and strange that they now teach the parents of my kids' school starting in second or third grade the math. Because I was like, well, you carry the one, and they're like, We don't do it that way anymore. You don't carry anything. You round up and you put it side by side. It's stupid. It's stupid now.
Yes.
Stop. I was like, what do you mean you don't use your fingers?
Yeah, well, I'm so
taking old. You out of that school.
I'm so old, we had an abacus back when I did math. You and I doing this. Oh, yeah. But, you know, I would imagine, I mean, I'm a lot older than all you whippersnappers in here, but we didn't have the interwebs back in my day.
No.
Can't you just be like, how do I do a parabola?
Well, you can do all of that, and a lot of their homework is based on the interweb. And a lot of it is like group study sessions with the interweb.
Wow.
Coming in. I mean, it's like a whole world out there that I don't, you know, I like a book, and I like get a book, go to the library, use the Dewey Decimal System, and my kids are like, when you speak, we don't understand you. But I think there's something to doing it the old-fashioned way, but I mean, I still have a library card, so I just have, you know, I have nostalgia in my heart.
Right.
Speaking of nostalgia, I started telling Jerry this backstage. So I signed up for Pinterest because I like to get pictures of haircuts because I'm always looking for my, one day my haircut will come in. I will figure it out and I will get this hair thing down.
Sure. It's like a Pinterest board.
Until then, I'm just gonna have Pinterest boards of other people's haircuts. Last night, something popped up for me, and it was me. I didn't ask for it. I didn't ask for it, because my Pinterest is not, my Pinterest, like my name for Pinterest isn't my, it's not Kelly Ripa,
right.
But Kelly Ripa popped up. They were like suggesting to me that I should try my haircut. So I decide to click on Kelly Ripa to see what's going on out there on the Kelly Ripa Pinterest pages.
All nudes.
No. No. Don't applaud that. It's really gross. You've clearly never seen me nude. Okay. So what it is, it's basically a walk down memory lane. And it was so depressing.
No.
It was so depressing. And I kept showing Mark. I was like, look, look at me here. Look at how young I am. Look at our kids. Look at how tiny they are. Look at how good my hair was. Look at my good outfit. He goes, you hated the way you looked then. You hated your hair. And he was like, roll. And so basically it was a lesson because Mark, because every picture I showed him, I was like, look how much better I looked then. Look how much better I looked then. And he was like, here's the thing. You need to stop with the vanity because in next week, a picture of you from today, you'll say, look how much better I was then.
Right, right.
So he's like, this is an exercise in like self-harm. He's like, get off that Pinterest page and block whatever that is.
Well, I would imagine, you know, you're a Jersey girl, so your hair was at one point like this, and then it went
like
this.
Well, I mean, it's still like my hair naturally wants to be twice its size.
Is this a Brazilian, what they call a Brazilian blowout? Is this straightened?
No, this is...
I have a house full of girls. I know these things.
No, this is just... We just blew this out straight. This is just a straight power blowout. This is my newscaster hair.
You know, let me... And it looks good. Let me just tell you what's funny, because I have gone down the Kelly Ripa, Mark C. road on Pinterest. You guys, unlike a lot of other couples in Hollywood, have been together so long, your pictures together are going to span, decades.
Yeah, and unfortunately, he looks exactly the same, is really nuts. The only difference is like which leg his boot is on, you know,
because he's constantly breaking. No, not true. You guys look amazing, and you know it, but you know they do. But Mark does look good. I want Mark to train me, man. That guy looks good.
Good.
I want to I follow him around the gym, and I'm like, okay, he's doing that. Okay, he's doing that. Be like Mark.
It's so unfair. I got to tell you, and you two are the same. You're like you're the tall, young version of us. but he is really, I think he gets better with age, which is starting to irritate me. I used to like wake up early and like look at him and be like, my gosh, he just wakes up like that. And now I wake up before him and I look at him and I'm like, ugh.
No, he is.
He looks so tan in those white sheets. Why is he always tan? Why are his teeth so white?
This is going to get weird with me talking about your husband so much.
Okay,
he's an athlete. He's just a very good-looking guy, and so are all your kids and everything. All right, enough of that. Listen, we have serious business here.
Yeah.
Guys, I'm sure a lot of you can use this as an excuse today if you have to call in school or work. There is a pretty crazy stomach flu out there, a norovirus. I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing that.
Ooh.
A school district in St. Charles in Illinois says that 800 students were absent yesterday and classes are now canceled. So wash your hands, people.
Oh.
We have a lot of people here.
There's been a lot of
a lot of people.
Here's what we've had going on here, guys. And I don't want to alarm you because you're stuck in this building with us for a while. But here's what we've had going on. Random bouts of nausea. Like people running out of the room. Almost like if I didn't know any better, and if we weren't so old, and if some of us weren't men, I'd swear we were all pregnant. Like everybody just will be like, so anyway, and then I said, and out the door. And that has happened like a lot. It's been going on a lot here.
Well, I mean, I guess, look, I'm no Dr. Gupta here, okay, but...
You're Dr. Gupta.
I'm no Dr. Oz, but, I mean, it's just going around, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, we have a producer that we talk to every day who texted me late last night and said, I'm sorry, I'm not going to be in. I'm not feeling too good down there.
Yeah, and did...
I don't want to go into detail, but... I mean, she said she had the poopies.
Yeah, well, no, her daughter was sent home sick from school yesterday. Her daughter, like, threw up her medicine.
Yeah, that's scary. Yeah. You know, I mean, I remember once one emergency room trip, and it's crazy because her daughter's younger, so it's that time when I remember
it
nursery school,
really,
my kids.
Right.
But my kids always got sick in nursery school. But one time, one of my daughters couldn't stop throwing up, and it was scary, you know? We had to go to the hospital, and they gave her the IV, and... It's just such a scary, scary thing when they're that young.
Yeah,
they can't really communicate. Now they just can communicate and complain too much. I wish they couldn't talk anymore, but...
I always say that I can tell... I can tell when one of my children, and she will remain nameless, when one of my children is not feeling well, she becomes very nice. So when she becomes nice to me, I'm like, come here, let me take your temperature. Like, that's the first sign. It's not really, you know, because Michael always, his ears would get red, and that's how I would know something's about to go down. Or Joaquin would get very pale, something's about to go down. But Lola becomes super nice, and then I'm like, she's about to become sick because she's become super... Is Brian sick? Is that really happening?
I hear he's not feeling well.
Is
Brian,
he directing?
Do you have the stomach thing?
Are you directing?
Yes, I have a stomach virus, something. Not feeling well at all.
Ah.
Okay. Well, let's stay away. Let's everyone stay away from our boss, Brian.
Right.
Everybody's keeping their distance from me out here.
Wait, but you're up in that you're up in that control booth. Like, that is the vomit comet up there.
When I told them I wasn't feeling well, nobody was very excited to see me.
Right. So what happens if you have to leave, say, to go use the facilities? Who takes over?
Sheila could do it.
I have the garbage pan right here.
By the way, I feel like we're talking to God here. It's like, God?
Hello,
Jerry. he has a good voice, Brian.
Why do my
children have a good voice? You should be on camera, Bri.
I can get used to this.
Yeah. Gosh, this is so exciting.
You're making me feel better already.
Oh, my gosh. You sound great. Yeah, it's like a lot of people will, call in sick here, but then you can tell if a person's calling in sick, they're not really sick, by how sick their voice sounds.
Right.
Right? Yeah. When they're like, Gilman, I can't make it.
Yeah, the sick voice.
Right? The sick voice.
Messages, yeah.
Right. Whereas...
Also, if Art is, like, partying at night, and he's like, hey, what's up? I'm going to be sick tomorrow. Woo! Zach, I'll call you later.
He's very stoic, though, Art. He'll just have a Bloody Mary and come into work. He doesn't mind.
Old school, man.
Listen, I don't know. Any of you guys from out west, the mountain areas? Anybody? Anybody at all? Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're probably, like, stuck here, right? Because there's severe weather. Did you know about this?
Yeah.
Did you know that you're experiencing severe weather at home? Well, just listen up. I'm going to tell you. 7 feet of snow in 7 days at California ski resorts. They are rejoicing because this doesn't just affect... Are you being sick? Are you sick? Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. We started it. Are you happy now?
The power of suggestion.
We just suggested that we're all sick here, and two people just threw up and left.
Like the show.
Maybe they didn't like the show.
What would it do to our ratings if the entire audience and all of us got the poopies?
Well, if you on camera, that could do
That would be amazing.
This is crazy.
Right?
People really got sick.
People
it's happening, everybody.
Wow.
Wash your hands.
Got sick. Where were they sitting?
What do they call it? The sanitizer?
Oh, my gosh. Lady, hold your breath for 10 seconds.
That's what
I do on the street. If somebody sneezes or coughs near me, do you all do this? I go...
Oh.
Ah. And then I go about my business, right, as if that's done something.
Right.
Anyway, so this doesn't just affect the great skiing of these ski resorts. This also affects the horrible drought that you right. all have been sure. under in California. Sure. So this is very exciting. In Squaw Valley, they have 173 mile per hour winds. Yeah, well, how about
even
that?
Get that high? Is that like a record? What is that? Isn't that like hurricane?
Yeah,
like,
it's more than hurricane.
It's, yeah. So, but I mean, I wonder, like, do people still ski when they have that kind of, like, can they ski?
No.
Would this be what the skiing would look like? Like, you'd be going downhill, but you wouldn't move. See, because the wind would hold you.
You know what?
This is how I look when I
That was amazing. You know what? Kelly, I thought you were Eddie the Eagle there. My yeah. mind was blown there. That was amazing. You were like Alberto Tomba.
Also, they've closed some ski resorts in Colorado. Monarch Mountain and... and Crested Butte, they're having a unique problem. They've gotten too much snow, so they've had to close down the ski resorts there. I don't know. They say stay tuned to their Facebook pages for information if you're planning a trip there. Mm. And California storms are adding 350 billion gallons of water to their reservoirs.
That's
so,
applaud for water.
Yay, water.
Water is very exciting, especially out there. And people going back out west, check your flights and make sure that they're still going. Hey, listen, we have a great show today. I'm so excited. This guy's for real. From the new film Silence, Andrew Garfield is here.
And from the series The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt, Tituss Burgess is here. Yeah. This is serious now. Let's get out our weapons.
Here we go. Okay. You ready? It's gonna snow, just like out west, everybody. It's gonna help our drought.
I do wanna run to the bathroom with this, with the two people, and be like, get out of here!
Oh, Gilman, can we do that?
Wouldn't that be fun?
Yeah.
Wouldn't that make their day?
I think it's hilarious. Kelly, what time is it?
It's time for Winter Lip Sync Travel Trip.
I just got a spanking. I've been
about sure it. You guys were good together, by the way. You were in perfect sync. That's Flo. Okay, Flo, I'm going to try to say your name the correct way. Flo Ramanauskas?
Very close.
Very close. How? Say it.
Ramanauskas.
Ramanauskas.
That's pretty close.
All the way from Melbourne, Australia. Yeah. Yeah.
Love it. Love it.
Yeah, yeah. I like it. How are things down under?
Great. Thanks.
Great. Good.
It's actually summer down there, so
it is.
Like, you must be freaking out. It's so cold here.
Yeah, but it's exciting. I've never seen snow.
All right. Well, give it another couple days.
You'll get over it real quick. Yeah.
On the phone, we have Maria Barna from Freeland, Pennsylvania. What up, Maria?
Hi, Kelly. Hi, Jerry.
How are you?
How's Freeland today?
Oh, not so good. We have covered with ice storm.
An ice storm.
Yeah, the schools are delayed and maybe even closed.
But it's
going to warm up. It's going to warm up.
It's going to be 60.
This is what we say in the Northeast, isn't it? Yes, it's freezing today, but it's going to warm up.
61 tomorrow.
Yes,
61 right. tomorrow, but then, just in time for the weekend, it's going to plunge back down.
Right.
Yeah, and then people say that this is why we get sick, but then doctors will say, this is not why we get sick. We get sick because of viruses.
Yeah, well, I hope we don't get the virus.
You're not going to get it, Maria, because you're going to go away. Hey, here's a great prize, the Tonka Verde Ranch in Tucson, Arizona. Nice. 7 days, six nights. This is an all-inclusive trip. Wow. This trip provided in part by hotels.com. It's a prize valued at $6,500. You have 20 seconds and only one guess. Maria, good luck.
All right.
Thank you.
Maria?
Thank you.
We can help Maria out with the hashtag live with Kelly. Remember that, everyone. Okay, here we go. I give everybody time to fire up the old computer, okay? On yesterday's show, we talked with Kevin Bacon. In what city did Kevin Bacon say he met his wife, Kira Sedgwick?
They met in Boston.
Yeah. Congratulations, you and a guest will enjoy 7 days and six nights at Tonka Verde Ranch, located in Tucson, Arizona. Experience luxurious accommodations, authentic dining, unparalleled amenities, and an abundance of activities, including horseback riding, tennis, swimming, and more. Tonka Verde Ranch is a once-in-a-lifetime experience that can be enjoyed by all. Your prize is valued at approximately $6,500.
Maria, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
I just want to say one thing. Jerry really does care about the trivia callers more than anybody else. I just want to say that.
It keeps me up at night, folks. I'm not joking.
And you're three for three days in a row.
Yeah.
So congratulations,
really, like,
Jerry.
I really think about it. I really want everybody to win.
You're going to make the questions harder when Jerry's here? Nice. Terrific. All right, Maria, now you get to help make the day of a lucky member of our studio audience who will receive 8 play settings of American-made fine china from Lennox, valued at more than $500. So please pick a number between 1 and 203.
I'm going to pick number 1 today.
Kimmy Schmidt, Tituss Burgess. We'll open up Kelly's inbox to hear your comments and questions. And coming up next, Andrew Garfield.
Hey, welcome back.
Series The Young Pope on tomorrow's show.
Yeah.
Jude Law.
Yeah, wow. Jude Law. And from the television movie remake Beaches, Nia Long will be here.
Wind Beneath My Wings and John Leguizamo. Very excited for him as well. Oh, man, this guy has gone from Spider-Man to a...
both popped an Altoid when you came out here. Golden Globes. This weekend, you were nominated for Best Motion Picture for Hacksaw Ridge. You were incredible in that film. Well deserved. Something happened, though.
Yes.
Something I couldn't take my eyes off of.
Right.
And we just popped an Altoid in case.
Just in case.
Just in case. You never know.
I hope everyone else has popped an Altoid as well, because no one's safe.
Well, we're going to take a look at what happened, and then you can explain to us how this happened.
Losers.
You know, I zoomed in a little bit, and I thought I saw a little bit of tongue there, Andrew.
I mean, it's not a real kiss if it's not slightly French.
Yeah.
Now, I should tell you, you know, Kelly's been up for a lot of awards, and Kelly
I've
also
lost many Golden Globes.
Never wins. I mean, do you want to console Kelly right now? You guys both had Altoids.
I'm just kidding. Don't panic.
Okay.
He was like, oh my God, no.
It's only, I don't know.
Not since the movie Alien have I seen a reaction that terrifying.
No, I, you know.
Was that spontaneous or planned? Seriously.
You know what? It's an interesting thing because I said to Ryan when we first sat down next to each other, I said, if you win, I think we should kiss. And he, of course, was so game and up for it, and his wife Blake was up for it as well. She thought it was hilarious. And Ryan was like, okay, so if I win, I'm gonna turn to my wife, and last minute I'm gonna turn to you and just plant one on you.
Yeah.
So we were both very, very excited at the possibility. And then he didn't win. We were both disappointed. I was mostly disappointed that I wasn't going to get to kiss him. So I said to him, we could, it's win or lose, we could still just do it. Because there was a camera like on us. It was like, there was a camera on Ryan for his response to the other Ryan winning.
Right.
And we thought they could cut to that, and that would be just a funny little thing.
I'm going to tell you something. I almost never say this. I can't wait for the Academy Awards. I am very excited to see what happens next.
You guys are going to have to go to second base. It's going to happen. Now, listen, the kiss also sparked rumors because your character, Marvel character Spider-Man, may show up in a Deadpool sequel. Is that possible?
Oh, goodness. I no longer play that character. A wonderful actor called Tom Holland is now playing that character. Mm-hmm. The torch has been passed very, very gratefully to this wonderful young actor. So if that was to ever happen, I don't think it would be me, unfortunately, but maybe me and Ryan could find some other kind of vehicle for our passions. yeah, I don't know.
I like it. Whatever it is, I like it. We have to take a commercial break. We're going to come back and talk about Silence with Andrew Garfield when we return. We're back with Andrew Garfield, star of Silence, who gave me a medical exam during the commercial break. It was very exciting.
Full body.
I'm okay, right? My reflexes are fine?
You seem fine. You just might need a little bit of rest.
Good. Yeah, thank you. Yes, I do need that. So you were so terrific in Hacksaw Ridge.
We were talking
about this a little bit before. I've actually co-hosted this show with Vince Vaughn, and I just love him.
I love him too.
It has to be so much fun to go to work with him every day.
It really is. I always say this about Vince. It feels like I'm being tickled, even though he's not touching me. Whenever I'm with him, even when he's trying to have a sincere conversation with me,
yes.
I can't quite take it all that seriously because of his delivery and his general being. You know, there's those people that just that just get you.
Yes.
I struggle with that. I felt very, very bad because he was confiding in me a lot of things, and I was just laughing hysterically. But no, he's brilliant. He's so brilliant in the film, and he's so multifaceted, and he's a great serious actor as well as a great comedic one. And his films actually are kind of like a comfort blanket for me. Like there's a bunch of his since Swingers and Wedding Crashers and Dodgeball and all these movies. They're the kinds of films that I watch when I'm sick or when I'm about to go to sleep or when I just need to be reminded that there's good in the world.
Yeah,
I don't know. He holds that for me. So
me too. That's actually you've described him very well.
Mm.
You know, before you became a big Hollywood star, you were just an adorable little boy growing up in London. We have this cutest picture of you. I don't know where it came from, how we got it, but this is you wearing, I believe, a bread box cover and maybe a tea kettle cover.
It's a tea cozy.
A tea cozy,
on my
yes.
head.
I was going to go with Mario Brothers.
I don't know what inspired it. But it was my nana always said that I would go to clown college, and she was absolutely right. That was always going to be my destiny. Brings back
it's really
memories.
It's a sweet picture.
We'll see if we can get a tea cozy in the back for you. And you can pop it on.
Yeah.
We'll be right back with Andrew in a moment.
You play a Christian monastery and you travel to Japan at a time when Christianity was forbidden, but you're in search of your mentor. And so what happens? It takes you on the journey from their search for their mentor through...
Yeah, no, it's a pretty wild story, and it's based in history, and it's based in a true history where Christianity was outlawed by the shogunate in Japan in the 1600s, and they were just kind of enacting these terrible acts of torture and execution on
Christians.
Because they believed that foreign territories would send the priests first to convert people, and then history told them the Armada follows very, very soon after. So there was an understanding that the powers that be in Japan at the time were concerned. But these two men that myself and Adam Driver play in this film, we are on a mission to keep Christianity alive in the country that doesn't want it, which is kind of a strange mission to be on.
Yeah.
But also a one of very much passion, beauty, and also simultaneously to find our mentor, who we've been told has apostatized, which means has renounced the faith and therefore has been exiled from the church. So it's a very kind of deep spiritual journey where the character that I play goes on this journey of kind of the dissemination of his ego. He has to actually renounce his faith in order to serve God. It's this very, very strange dichotomy about what is it to live a life of faith? What is it to live a life of meaning? And it doesn't offer very many easy answers, which I think is a really important thing, because there aren't any easy answers to that question.
Well, we should also say the movie's directed by Martin Scorsese, New York's own, yeah. So we're really excited about that. Hey, a terrific actor on stage, on screen, everything. Silence is in theaters now. It opens wide this Friday. Coming up next, Tituss Burgess. You're the best, buddy.
I'm so happy to finally be here.
I've long since been a fan of yours.
Oh my gosh, thank you very much. The feeling is very mutual.
Well, thank you so much.
So you grew up in Georgia.
I did, down south. I came a long way, honey, to be here.
Are you freezing?
No, I love the cold.
You do?
I got off the plane in New York City and I was like, finally I'm home with my people.
What?
Yes,
Oh my gosh, I feel the reverse when I go to Georgia. I'm like, this feels right.
Honey, you can have it.
Really?
Yeah,
I love it. Did you really teach yourself to play the piano?
I did. My grandmother had an upright in her back room, and some of the keys were missing or whatever, and I would just be able to figure out where the harmonic structure was supposed to go. So strange. Anyways, that's boring. But yeah.
No, it's not.
I taught myself.
That's fascinating.
Not. It's amazing. I have to force my children to go to a piano lesson. I have to hold them there at the piano.
Oh, my mom would be like, knock it off, Tituss. But no, she loves it now, though.
Right, yeah. I bet.
Yeah.
And then you became the director, this is so interesting to me, of your church choir.
At a very young age.
Yeah.
Imagine, you know, a little 11-year-old telling all these adults what to do, because in the South, that does not fly.
Right. 11.
Yeah. And I just loved the noise and the feeling that I got when I could, you know, corral a group of people to do the right thing, if you will,
right.
And make the proper noise sonically. And it was so thrilling. So they let me do it.
Now, your voice, I've heard, can span 4 octaves.
Oh, Lord.
Come on, Mariah, let's hear it.
I will do it. My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile.
Oh. Oh man, they could have used you on New Year's Eve. They could have used you in that show.
I will not comment on that.
That was so gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
Oh my gosh.
That's so sweet.
I got chills. So you've done some Broadway work.
Yeah, I've been in a whole bunch of shows. I've not been on Broadway since about 2009. I hope to get back at some point. But
yeah, when are you going to go back?
Well, I'm writing a musical.
Oh, you really?
I am.
Jared.
I was able to buy the rights to The Preacher's Wife, which starred Whitney Houston in like
97. No kidding. Yeah.
So I'm writing a whole new score and all the lyrics for it. So.
Whoa.
I love how
that'll probably get to Broadway before I will. Listen.
Unbelievable.
I'm not waiting for anybody to give me an opportunity.
I've got to tell you, you are a take charge person,
yes,
and
ma'am.
I really love that. Obviously, you've been that way your entire life.
Well, thanks to my mom.
Thank you, Mom.
Thanks, Mom. We love you.
Listen. We're going to take a commercial break. When we come back, we're going to find out why Tituss had to audition for a part that was written for Tituss.
Toro on live, John Leguizamo.
That, of course, is Tituss. Tituss Burgess and the Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. That's a show about a young girl who spends years living in an underground bunker.
15 years in it doesn't sound like a bad idea right now, though. but yes, and she moves in with me. It comes to New York City like you do after you've been away from civilization for that long.
And
subsequently sort of teaches us all a lesson. She's a very sunny disposition, optimistic look on life. And it's a beautiful, funny, poignant little story.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, this character was written for you.
That's what they tell me. Tina said they wrote it with me in mind, but I still had to audition.
What is the character's name?
Tituss, with one S.
Oh, Tituss with one S.
There's a difference.
My name is
Tituss.
Right. So that's so interesting, though. You still had to audition.
I don't mind. I'll tell you this. I've had lots of career highs and career lows, and I don't think I would have been able to appreciate the job on the level which I do had I not gone through that process. I've had very few things handed to me in my life. So that situation, why should that situation have been any different? Mm. So I was equipped up here to go through the hoops. No one was going to take my job from me.
I'm staring at your beautiful eyes right now. I would hand you anything. I swear to God right now. I'll give you anything you want.
Oh my goodness, just more time with you on this.
Okay, you got it.
Tituss, you know what I'm dying to do? This. I gotta kiss you.
Go for it.
Had to do it. And he's nominated for a SAG! A SAG Award! You gotta do it! Hey, Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt is streaming right now on Netflix. Next up, we're gonna open up the inbox! If you like to take pictures of your pet, we have a contest for you!
We've partnered with Cats Pride for Life's Paw Paparazzi Photo Contest. Here are a few of the pictures we have received. These are not necessarily winners, we just want to point out.
These are just entries. Okay, the first one is, me with my cat. There we go. That's Smitty right there.
How about this one here of this adorable Shih Tzu named Chewy Consuelos? Yeah, wait a minute. Okay, Chewy's ineligible.
Here we go. This is from Talia McEwen from Philly, Pennsylvania. Does this compliment my wrinkles?
That's really cute. That's Donna Schweitzer from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. They say it's going to snow today. See the snow on the sea?
I like it. This is Scott B. from Commerce, Michigan. Gertrude airing it out into Grand Traverse Bay up at Yippee.
This is from Tiffany Gill in Baton, Texas. Our blue-eyed Huskinies. I've never heard of a Huskinies, but this dog is smiling. We can all agree.
Gorgeous. Are those like those color contacts? That's amazing.
Yeah.
This is from Melanie Rice in Galloway, New Jersey. My name is Chase, and my mommy rescued me from under the boardwalk in Atlantic City when I was just 4 weeks old.
Guys, this is Reg Conahan from PEI, Prince Edward Island. How about that?
Yeah.
And the cat is like, I'm so tired. I just want to stay here and fake smoke all day.
Yeah, PEI. Lisa Larson from Attleboro, Massachusetts. Holland Lop Ella over here. Cute.
This is from Morgan Stroyzik from Stevensville, Montana. Patio chair.
Yeah. Yummy.
Yeah.
Good one. Good. Now for our inbox. This is from Rebecca Watson in Greenwood, Delaware. For the past 5 days, I felt like I was nauseated and my head felt like I was going to pass out. Thank you for giving me a name for my sickness. Norovirus.
Katie Grinton from Richmond Hill, Ontario, said the norovirus is the worst! Exclamation point. It took out my niece's whole school, and public health had to come in and sanitize before the students would come back, and it was all over the evening news. Not the evening news!
Yeah. It's all over it. This is from Robin May in Tarrytown, New York. My dad always said my mom's tombstone would read, "She finally got her hair perfect." That's pretty funny.
Bonnie Moyer from Hatfield, Pennsylvania said, "I agree. Math today is stupid." They're not going to do it that way in the real world. Our way is easier. They need to teach cursive writing again, too. How can they sign? Yes!
Yeah.
They don't know how to sign their names. And you forget writing thank you notes. My gosh, what is happening? It is the downfall of society.
Guys, let's go start a protest after this. We want cursive writing.
Yes.
We want cursive writing. This is from Lisa S. in Staten Island, New York. Kelly, I stopped understanding math when my daughter was in first grade.
Yeah.
I'm with you there. I remember writing a note to her teacher saying, I have an education, but I don't understand fourth grade math. She assured me that I was not the only one and you are not alone.
Hey, thank you, Jerry.
Love you, baby.